Hello everyone. If you have ever visited a hospital, you must have visited the radiology department. Are you aware of radiation hazards in the radiology department? If you are exposed to unwanted radiation, what should you do? Can you breastfeed if you are exposed to X-rays? If you or your friend is pregnant and exposed to X-rays during pregnancy, what should you do? Does MRI scan contain radiation? These are the informations I will be providing you from this video. Welcome to Radio Clinics. Today's video presentation is on radiation hazards. What can radiation do? It can cause burns, cancer, infertility, cataracts, genetic effects, and even death. If you look at this table, you can see that if you are exposed to occupational hazards of radiation, it will decrease your life expectancy by 51 days, which is quite low in compared to cigarette smoking, but still higher than natural hazards like hurricane and earthquakes. The acute effects of radiation are burns, dizziness, vomiting. When exposed to large amount of radiation, there may be chronic effects of radiation like infertility and cataracts, and even cancer. X-ray, CT scan, mammogram, and fluoroscopy contain radiation, while ultrasound and MRI do not give harmful radiation. MRI works by the use of magnets, and ultrasound works by the use of sound. Hence, if you go to a MRI room or an ultrasound room, you don't need to worry about radiation. How do you protect yourself from radiation? Be aware of radiation signals. This circle with a fan-like shape is a radiation hazard signal. So is this triangle. This sign says you not to walk around. Before entering the radiology department, know what is the investigation being done. Keep your previous reports and films so that they don't need to be done again. If you are pregnant, be cautious while going to the radiology department. You should inform the clinicians that you might be pregnant so that the clinician requests for an alternate investigations for the diagnosis instead of an X-ray. When you reach the radiology department, tell the receptionist, the radiologist, or technologist that you might be pregnant. Radiation protective equipments like radiation protective glasses, radiation protective thyroid shield, and radiation protective jackets may be provided. The technicians will ask you to wear this when in need. For example, if your baby is undergoing an X-ray examination, the clinicians may ask you to wear radiation protective jacket, and you should comply with the procedure. What if you are pregnant and accidentally exposed during pregnancy? If it happens, so don't worry. If the child is more than 18 weeks in the second trimester or in the third trimester, the baby will be safe. In case of fetus within the first trimester or in early part of the second trimester, there may be risk of radiation hazards to the fetus, and the fetus may have mental retardation and other congenital ailments. So you should consult with a radiologist or a radiation expert if you are exposed to radiation during that period of pregnancy. There is no definite evidence for what radiation hazards may occur to the fetus, and it depends upon the dose of radiation. So if you are exposed to less radiation, there will be either no or less risk to the fetus. But if you are exposed to high amount of radiation, there might be risk to the fetus. But since you will never be knowing about the dose of radiation, you need to consult with a radiation expert on this matter. What about breastfeeding? If you are breastfeeding and are exposed to radiation, it is safe. No need to worry. You may continue breastfeeding. Radiation does not go through breast milk. What are the investigations in the radiology department that contain the most amount of radiation? The most radiation containing investigations in the radiology department are the CT scan and fluoroscopy. CT scan consists of multiple X-rays which are sent to the body at the same time to construct three-dimensional structure of a body to diagnose diseases. Fluoroscopy is a technique of non-static X-rays. This takes images of organs of your body which might be moving by the use of X-rays. For example, fluoroscopy is used to see the mobility of your intestines and the mobility of the urinary bladder while you are peeing or menstruating. A CT scan done for your belly or abdomen gives approximately 5000 times more radiation compared to the standard X-ray of the chest. If radiation is so harmful, why should I undergo CT scan or X-rays? We doctors and radiation experts don't let you undergo unnecessary investigations when not required. Most diseases in your chest, abdomen, and bones can only be diagnosed with the help of a X-ray or CT scan. The benefit to the patient versus the risks of radiation is always evaluated by the clinician and the radiologist. If the investigation is deemed unnecessary for the diagnosis of your diseases, it is usually not performed. If the investigation is deemed necessary, it can't be avoided, which can increase in morbidity and even death. Are radioactive substances which contain large amount of radiation used in the radiology department? Radioactive substances are used in the Department of Nuclear Medicine to diagnose and treat different diseases. Radioactive substances contain large amount of radiation and these are used in diagnosis and treatment of only specific diseases. Previously, in old times, radiology and nuclear medicine were only one department. Now, in recent times, radiology and nuclear medicine are different, so radioactive substances are not used in the Department of Radiology.